Hey Survivors, Skippy 3 here again. Welcome to episode 22 of Let's Play PS4 7 Days to Die. Now I'm underneath, I still haven't named this yet. I'm actually recording this video pretty much a couple hours after releasing my other videos. So I'm going to give you guys a chance this video too to make suggestions for what I should name this base. So I don't have a name for it yet, but I'm beneath my kill base here. And what I've started to do is I've placed in all my forges that I made ahead of time, and I've started putting in supply chests so I can fill these suckers up. The other thing I've also done too is on the floor I've noted C and then N, and that means, to me at least, I know this on multiplayer it'd not be so clear, but I know in these ones I'm putting coal and nitrate into them. Oops, that's a forge. This one's going to be my iron, and of course this one's going to be my stone. Wood can go into this one, and lead into this one, and then you got your clay and your sand. And the other ones will be overflow as I get more and more resources. So as I dig, because it's going to be really close to where my underground city is, I'll bring it all up here, store it in here, and have these forges running full blast all the time, and we will never have to worry about resources ever again. There'll be so many resources, not even funny, because when these are all running, it will attract screamers. The screamers will walk, fall in down here, they won't be able to see me, and they'll just die crawling across the spikes. So now I have like a base that's completely solid that I can go underground for days and not even have to worry about the screamers or anything. So I'm pretty excited about that. You guys are going to see some major building going on from here on out. Now, once again, too, guys, like as always, I want to thank you for your amazing support in this series. It really drives me to make new videos every day. I love playing this game, so making videos is not hard. I love making videos, but it does take a lot of time, so that encouragement is always great. Now, also, too, guys, I'm going to actually start running back and forth and grabbing some more supplies from the main area here. But as I do that, I want to talk to you guys about everyone's attitude about 7 Days to Die. Now, you got the PC Master Race. And I use this term loosely, guys. Not every PC user is a PC Master Race. I have a good PC. I love gaming on it, but I also like my console. Now, you got the PC Master Race bitching about console. Oh, it's going to take the fun pimp's attention away from the PC release. Console doesn't deserve a game like this. It's an alpha. Console doesn't want alpha games. And then you got the console players who are like, what the hell is this? This is an alpha game? We don't like alpha games. We don't tolerate this crap. We want full, complete games. I want to be able to pick it up and not have a bug. Well, first of all, PC Master Race, you guys are a bunch of idiots, because now there's 3 studios working on bug fixes, not one. And for console users, you guys want a complete game? Why do you keep accepting games like Fallout 4, Grand Theft Auto 5, all those games that continue to have game-breaking bugs 6 months after release? Grand Theft Auto 5, 2 years after release, or it's even more than that. But seriously, guys, like, use your brain, right? Like, you'll pay $120 for a AAA release with all the expansion content and completely overlook game-breaking bugs. I like I said, Fallout 4 corrupted on me like 5-6 times. Like, it was frustrating from the storyline, not even from what I was doing. It corrupted from the storyline because of all the variables with it. And you know what? That is okay. Games will have bugs. They'll always have bugs. There's no such thing as a perfect game. But for some reason, everyone bitches when they spend $30 on the game that it has some launch bugs. Like, come on, guys. That leads me into my next topic here, which is actually Mad Mole posted on the forums just a few hours ago. And this is the words out of his own mouth, all right? So if you guys are going to argue this with me, don't, because it's completely useless. It comes from the co-founder of 7 Days to Die. Alright, so he posted about 4 hours ago, as of this recording, some really great news. IG, which is Iron Galaxy, which is working with Telltale on 7 Days to Die, has found the reason for the stuttering, and we fixed some of the issues. And we're working on them for the others. So, like I said, guys, multiple studios, multiple bug fixes. Nothing wrong with that. It's actually a good thing. I love seeing communities come together, like different consoles or different platforms of gaming coming together. It's beautiful. It's a good thing. It's a really good thing. Why the heck people separate themselves on the console or the platform that they're gaming on is beyond me. Like, it boggles my mind. But, okay, and then it goes on to continue to say, we're working on them for others, but that is definitely a big benefit from console coming to PC. Or, Yeah, or the other way around. You know, you guys know, I think you know what he meant by that. Stuttering has been around since Alpha 1, so I will be very happy to see it resolved once and for all. So for all you console users that are like, it's unplayable because of the stuttering, the PC version is so much better. It happens on PC constantly too. I don't know where all you guys got this information where you think the bugs in this game don't happen on PC. But like he said, it's been around since Alpha 1, and his studio has not been able to cure it. But now that IG has been working on it, Iron Galaxy, which is another small studio as well, they have found the bug because they've had time to do it while the fun pimps are busy adding content in. So this is a great thing for everybody, guys. I personally am extremely, extremely excited about it. I was excited day one when I heard it was coming to console and that two studios were going to be working on it. I literally pissed myself. Like, not literally. I actually didn't piss myself. I wear diapers because, you know, you don't want to mess up your laundry. But anyways, that's a whole other issue we can talk about in another video. But thanks for listening to my little bit of a rant about that, guys, because it's been driving me absolutely nuts with people separating their gaming consoles on how games should run. Like, I just hate that attitude. Oh, we're on console, we don't accept games with bugs in it. That's the one of the stupidest statements I've ever heard, because honestly, guys, console games are way fucking buggier than PC games. I'm sorry, but that's the truth. PC games, you can fix them. Console games, you don't have a fucking choice. You gotta deal with the bugs, right? Because on PC, like, there's other people who make, like, little small patches that temporarily fix the bugs, or they have a workaround for it until the developer comes out with it. But you can't do that crap on console, you know what I mean? But console's great, because you plug it in, you start it, and it goes, right? So, I mean, they both have their ups and downs, but I'm getting really tired of hearing about those attitudes. And honestly, I've deleted a lot of the, like, that shitty attitude off of my videos because I just simply do not want it. That's why I'm excited for games like Boundless. That's going to be crossplay over PC and PlayStation 4. Yes, unfortunately, guys, Sony did buy the rights for Boundless, and you won't be able to play it if you're on Xbox One. It's unfortunately the part of the industry. But hopefully that is a trend that'll go away in the future, because honestly, I don't like exclusives either. I think they're stupid. It's just a way to take advantage of the console market. But you know what? They do have their place as well, too. Because if you thought about it, if consoles didn't have exclusives, what would really be your reason to buy one console over another, right? Like, if you're a huge Halo fan, you don't buy a PS4, or you get a PS4 and an Xbox. But you guys know what I mean. Like, it's just, it's ridiculous the attitude everyone's been taking lately. And I'm glad to see this announcement, because it just goes to show you what putting two, three heads together can really do for you. So I'm excited that that's coming out. And they didn't mention too, if I go back and look at the forum here, Roland, the community moderator for 7 Days to Die forums, he said he copied over the original post from Madman to the console side, because Madman posted it over on the PCs, or Mad Mole posted it over to the PC side. He's a busy guy. I'm amazed this guy even bothers communicating with the fans of the game. Like, how much time he spends on developing. And then he goes, IG stands for Iron Galaxy, for those who didn't know that, because I don't know why, guys. When you load up the fucking game on console, it has three splash screens. It has Fun Pimps, Telltale, and Iron Galaxy. And I don't know why the console people keep blaming the Fun Pimps for all the problems on console, which already exist on PC, but they're working together to fix. But yeah, he goes, IG stands for Iron Galaxy, which is the development team responsible for the ported version of 7 Days to Die. He goes, no word yet on whether the stuttering fix will make it in patch 2 due out very soon. So that's a big sign, guys, that patch 2 is like almost good to go. But what he's saying pretty much is they just found the solution for the stuttering. So he doesn't know yet if that's going to be in patch 2 or not. But that, I mean, that's just fantastic that they fixed that issue, because honestly, it used to really drive me crazy on PC. Because on PC, it's much easier to move a lot quicker and make a lot more mistakes, because the controller is a little bit slower than a mouse and keyboard, but honestly, I like the controller better. But that is just excellent, great news, guys. And then he just finishes off saying, or if it'll be part of the next one. So, I mean, we got patches coming. You guys have been incredibly patient. You know, a lot of people, they decided to take a mature standpoint on it and said, I love 7 Days to Die. For me, the game is unplayable. I don't know. I guess I have more patience than the average person. But for them, they're like, the game is, for me, is unplayable, but I love the game, and I realize that it has launch bugs. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it down for now. I'm going to go play some other games because it's an amazing world. There are a ton of games out there that you can play. And when they patch it, I'll come back and I'll enjoy the fuck out of the game. And that is a great mentality to have, really. Because, I mean, when Grand Theft Auto 5 came out, I was so pumped about the multiplayer aspect of it. And they didn't fix the multiplayer aspect of it for like a month. And then after that, there were so many glitches and they ruined the economy on the game. That is just, it was unplayable. To me, it was incredibly unplayable. Like, it was unfair, the economy sucked, and there was people hacking it, and it was just, it was brutal, right? But what I did was I put the game down, waited them for to fix that stuff, and then I started playing it again once they fixed those issues up. No, I mean, that game didn't last very long for me because it got a little repetitive and boring over time. I like to see what I've done. That's why I think I like building games, is because I can build, and then step back and see what I've done. I'm like, damn, right? Like, I've spent 100 hours and this is what I've done. Games like that, you spend 100 hours on it and you're like, what have I done? Like, you have stats and stuff, right? But I mean, you can only look at your stats so much. At least this gives you more of a visual representation of what you've accomplished. And other news too, guys, I guess I may as well just keep talking away here while we're doing this crazy stuff. I think this is going to be more of an update episode than anything else, considering we just did the 56-day horde last episode, and it went incredibly well. I've been talking to my buddy White Marcella, and I'm actually thinking of making a second channel. Because one thing I've always wanted to do, but I just never had maybe the material or just the confidence to do it, is I want to make like more of a talk show style thing, not necessarily about gaming, just more of like a comedic take on current events and stuff like that. So I've been talking to my friend White Marcella, and we're really thinking about launching one. So I may be making a second channel here soon, and I'll start advertising it in my videos, obviously. And you guys are more than welcome to check it out. If you like my style of comedy, I've kind of thrown it into a few of the videos here and there. I'm trying to incorporate it. You know, it's hard to incorporate comedy and educational stuff at the same time, at least I find. But I've been trying to do it, so if you guys have any suggestions, you know what I mean, definitely let me know. I'd love to hear from you guys. But yeah, so that's up and coming. I don't really have a channel update video this week, so I'm kind of doing it all in this one video as I go, because I got a lot of organizing and stuff to do now, so this is quite a bit of work. I almost got all my supplies over, though. That's sick. Oh, look at that. I have enough animal hide there to make another forge. So what I'm going to do with that area is just continue to fill it up with chests, continue to fill it up with forges, and then eventually that whole room, like, I'll have a whole ton of forges going in it. And you guys want to talk about a freaking heat map? Damn, that's going to create a heat map and a half. And it'll be fun to watch, just watching the screamers killing themselves, falling into the pit. But once again, guys, definitely throw your comments down in the section. I want to hear some good names. If you're gonna make it sexual, you know, at least make it witty. Have some witty stuff. I was thinking about calling it the V-Pit after Viagra, because it kind of looks like, you know, I got the sniper tower coming out of the middle. Or I was going to call it my fucking base, because literally it kind of looks like the sniper tower is fucking my base. I don't know. It's kind of lame, but I'm really at a loss for the name for this base, because it's definitely a different style. I've never done this style before. Okay, cool. So what I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to finish up some organizing here, and then I'll come back, and we'll do some upgrading, I think. I need some more steel and some more concrete, and we'll do some building and whatnot, and I'll do that very soon. See you guys soon. Okay, and we're back. So, what I think I'm going to do, guys, because I do have to make a buttload, I thought I heard a fire zombie, a buttload of spotlights to light up that whole area that the zombies come at me from, because as we found out last episode, I can't see shit when they get the horde. So what we're going to do is we're going to go out and we're going to go to the biome next to us here, this one right here. I'm going to scout a place nearby that I can throw a different entrance into, because I want to switch out this entrance. This one's only a temporary one. I kind of actually want to make it into one of the little prefab thingies. But this biome here is loaded with random cars and is loaded with random loot as well, too. So we're going to go out there. We're going to do some gathering up and whatnot. And get going here. And once again, guys, like I said, I'm forced to record this episode during the day. So if you do hear any background noise, I do apologize. I do live above or below heavier people. Oh, yep, I got some attention up there. So what I'm going to do is... Oh yeah, this is my only way out. What am I doing? Oh wait, no, it's not my only way out. What I'm going to do... my heat map must be crazy because I was letting that forge run for a while. What I'm doing with the forge here is I'm pulling out the clay and getting some steel arrowheads. I'm on fire. How am I? Oh, there it is. There it is. Let's drink some water. Oops, I can't drink water. Oh, good thing I have health kits. Oh, that wasn't too bad. Which way do I need? Oh, I need to go this way. Wow, I'm so distracted. Oh, yeah, like I said, I have nothing against heavier set people, but, like, guys, seriously, if you live above somebody else, take it easy on the goddamn floor. There is no reason to stomp around. I'm actually looking for a newer place myself. I want to buy, but there's a big bubble right now where I am, and I really don't want to overpay for a place. And the landlord on top of that is selling this place too, so I'm going to have a lot of bullshit to deal with people coming in and out and invading my privacy. And yeah, I'm not into that at all. So I am looking for a new place, but once again, guys, like I said, I usually record late at night, but because I have to work tonight 4 to 12, it's going to be a little hard to release this episode on time, and then on Friday, record another hour-long episode for Saturday. So I'm recording this one during the day. First time during the day. It's been a while, but... Okay, cool. So I'm going to get these wood frames in here. And we'll get my butt up there. At least distract the zombies and pull them away. I'm not going to fight them this time because it is still nighttime. Oh, damn it. It's still nighttime, so... So I won't be able to fight them efficiently. It's really, really dark out, and they're tougher at night. So I can just avoid them, and we'll go for a run here. Wow, that almost pushed me off. What do I got blocking me? Oh, this is blocking me. Okay. Let's get rid of this. Just work my way up. But yeah. So I got. Hopefully, I can find a place quite quickly. I've been looking around. Prices for rentals have really dropped in the last little while. Like when I was looking before, this place is overpriced. It's incredibly overpriced, but it was the cheapest place at the time. But now I'm just paying way too much for it, and my landlord's turned out to be a complete douche and won't work with me at all on showing times and whatnot, and completely lies to me about showing up, and I actually have to, like, get up in the middle of my sleep or stuff like that, and just doesn't bother showing up. So yeah, it's been like a whole thing with this landlord. This landlord's turned into a complete bitch. She's separating with her husband, and, like, is just on a complete man rage right now. She hates men and everything, and I'm just getting the brunt end of it as well too. So I don't appreciate that, but it is what it is, and you know what, I'll just move on, right? It's not like I need this place. I can find another place and no freaking problem. The only other part too is I do have a large dog, as you guys know. You've probably seen Lex at some point in time. But yeah, he's a very large dog. He's very domesticated. He's older. He's 17. He doesn't do much. He just kind of sits around and loves everything. So trying to find a place with a dog is a hard thing. But I just recently found out that they passed a law here that your landlord cannot actually dictate if he can have an animal or not in the house. The only way they can ever evict you for having an animal is if that animal poses a threat to other residents in the building. And I mean, this dog, I really have no concerns about him threatening anybody. I mean, the worst he's going to do is threaten you with some kisses. You know what I mean? Like, he's such a great dog. I love him to death. But yeah, so I've been going through that. So there might be a little bit of an interruption in videos while I'm doing a move or whatnot, and it's going to be a little bit of a busy time for me, especially considering too, I'm looking for a place right now, and I'm going to be looking at the same time as college students. So I'm going to be having a fight with college students for places to live. I do, like, where I live, there's not very many jobs. There's a lot of minimum wage jobs. You know what I mean? It's not like it's a booming economy, but for some reason the housing market is in a huge bubble. Like, when I left 6 years ago to move out west, an average house sold for about 100k, and now that I've moved back 6 years later, there's no better jobs here. The jobs are still the same bullshit jobs, but now that I moved back, for some reason those same houses are selling for close to three. So I don't know what the heck, like, I don't know who's buying these homes or what's going on with that, but wow. Yeah, I really don't get it. So I'm kind of waiting for the bubble to pop. It seems almost like they're giving anybody credit for any reason. Like, I don't know why someone making a minimum wage should be able to get a $40,000 car on a loan. That to me is like irresponsible loaning, period. They're not going to be able to afford that. If they lose their minimum wage job, I guarantee you not a single one of them have a savings. If you're paying $600-$700 a month on a car and you work a minimum wage job, that's almost half your damn wages. You know what I mean? Like, it's gotten out of hand. I know this happened in 2008 but in the States, and for some reason we're doing the same crap here. So I'm kind of waiting for that bubble to pop. I'm waiting for my opportunity. You know what I mean? It's going to suck. A lot of people are going to lose their homes, but it's going to be good news for me because homes will be selling for next to nothing. It's going to be like Detroit all over again, but here. And for me, I love this area. It's a beautiful, beautiful area. My YouTube's working out for me, so I don't really have to work. I do work to keep my foot in the door just in case something happens. You know what I mean? I work overnights at Tim Hortons, as I explained in the one episode, which is really funny too, because I was went to preview one of my videos on YouTube, and I actually got a Tim Hortons ad playing on the same video where I was describing working at Tim Hortons. It's almost like Google knows. It's like, well, I listened to your video and you mentioned Tim Hortons, so I'm going to put up Tim Hortons ads. It's just a coincidence, but I think it's pretty funny. Oh my goodness, batteries are so hard to get. I do love this biome though. Like, if you guys are first starting out, I really, 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 really recommend just hitting up this biome, because you got like tons of these little prefabs, and each one of these you get like lockers with stuff in it. You get coolers that can give you actually really decent food. You know, there's tons and tons to loot. Of course, I've already looted these, so let's go to an area that I haven't looted yet. Oh, okay, we'll continue down this way here. We'll continue down the road stealing cars and then looting whatever else might be around, while I blabber on about stuff, random stuff that has nothing to do with 7 Days to Die. That's pretty much what these episodes are going to be like now, because, oh, look at that, an airdrop. Because honestly, like, I can talk so much about 7 Days to Die, but half an hour is quite a bit to fill up. So I hope you guys do enjoy my stories, you know what I mean? I try to do my best to tell them in a good manner without saying too much, because for some reason, there are very few people out there, but the few people that do really hate it when you say I don't know why. It's a part of normal human speech. Like, I do try to avoid saying it, but it is what it is, right? You're going to say every once in a while. I mean, talking to friends, they say so either deal with it or don't watch my videos. Ooh, here you go, guys. I know a lot of people are asking about wheels for mini bikes. If you take your fire axe, and on these prefabs, every once in a while you'll get a tire on them. If you hit that tire, oh, I didn't get it. It's like looting. You actually have a chance of looting a tire from that, like a set of mini bike tires. Hopefully I can find one that'll do it. None of that I want. And I'm also doing all this looting too to try to get my scavenging skill up. I really desperately need to get that up as well too. Now, I definitely hit up all the toilets because they do give handguns and ammo, so that's always a good thing. Let's see here. See? I just said again. Nice. Now I'm going to point it out every time I say it. And I love how you guys point out the funny things I say too, like the what I do. You know what I mean? It's just it's something for some reason you get into habit of saying things that are completely wrong, and you keep on saying them. But you know what? It's part of me. It's part of who I am. I love it. I embrace it. Oh, a little bit of leg there. Oh, I can't wait till they fix that leg bug. I am so pumped to see Mad Mole say that. Now, I am active on the 7 Days to Die forums. You know what? Actually, I should hit up all these supply crates while I'm out here. Ooh, sniper receiver. I'm not going to take the stock, the beaker. Antibiotics I'll take. I'll leave all that other stuff. I totally lost track of what I was going to say there. That airdrop excited me. Where did my ranch go? Here we are. Cool. But yeah, I love this biome, hands down. This is the best biome to go looting in. No battery. Sometimes you can loot the battery straight out of the car as well, too. I do need more engines because I need to make more concrete mixers for that for the forage area down there. So I'm definitely going to be hitting those up. And this is what I said to people, too. Everyone's like, oh, why don't you go after your airdrops all the time? This is what I do, because they all end up landing in the same damn area anyways. I know that, so I'm going to just take it. I know this one, too. That increases my science, though, so I'm actually going to go ahead and read that one. Because there's not really much... Like, you can increase science, but whatever. Or health. Oh, yeah, science. Derp. And then I'm going to scrap that one to make paper. Cool. Now let's see if I can find some more tires. I don't really need many bike tires at this point in time. And I did get a lot of feedback on the last video where you guys were like, well, what's wrong with the mini bike? I've had the mini bike on my map for the longest time. Guys, what it is your mini bike will get... no mini bike tires. I want to show you guys getting mini bike tires here. still no mini bike tires. Okay, but anyways, what happens, guys, is that there's a placement glitch when you load the game in and out, or you load... Ooh, blueberries, I'll take that, I don't have those seeds yet. When you load in and out of the chunk, it'll replace the mini bike down like it wasn't there, and sometimes what happens is it actually gets placed underground, like literally in the ground, in the space that it shouldn't exist in, and what that does on console is it actually corrupts your game save, it won't be able to load it. So that's what I'm talking about when I'm saying be careful with your mini bikes. If you're going to use it, be very careful. If the game crashes while you're on your mini bike, you could lose your mini bike. So if you have anything in the basket on the mini bike, you lose that as well. But if you are going to have a mini bike, guys, place it on player placed blocks. When you park it, make sure it's player placed blocks, because that'll help avoid the bike getting placed underneath the ground. That's what we do on PC to avoid those problems. Because yes, guys, we do have the same problems on PC. You know what I mean? Ah, there we go. Got some mini bike tires. There we go. 351. So that's an easy way to find mini bike tires, guys. It's so easy to get a mini bike going. I just won't, because I'm paranoid about having my map crash or having to re-record a whole episode because my map crashed while I was using the mini bike and corrupted it. And then I'll have to back up and then record a whole episode again. And that can be a butt ton of work. Like, it's too much work in my opinion. So I'm going to avoid it for now until they do come out with a console patch to fix those problems. Like I said, multiple teams working on the same thing. We're going to see bug fixes come up so fast now. I am so excited about that. Still no batteries yet, though. Dang it. Okay, cool. Yeah, none off that car. This biome seems to have a lot of cars in it, as I was saying earlier. I don't know if it necessarily has more full cars. There's a lot of frames. But it definitely does have a lot of that to offer. Let's get back to the roadway here where the cars are going to be. I haven't explored much south, so this actually works out. If I could find a lake south too, that would be cool. Maybe I'll make a lakeside cabin. Because at this point in the game, guys, now that I have my forage room, I have my kill base, I'm 100% set. Like, I don't need to really do much more. I can build, or I can produce stuff like crazy. I don't have to worry about defending myself. My mind is just reeling with how much stuff I can build right now. The underground city, I'm really excited to do that. I haven't done an underground city-like project yet, so that's going to be kind of cool. I think what I'm going to do is try to blend it in with the natural, like, underground landscape. Maybe do some, like, obviously building stuff, but... battery. No battery? Come on, battery. No battery. Batteries can be such a pain in the ass to get. Ooh, my inventory is full. If I do get a battery, what'll happen is it'll end up dropping to the ground. So I'm actually going to get rid of it. No, I'm going to keep that iron. 7 wood frames, I get rid of those. Okay, cool. Batteries can be like such a pain in the ass to get. But you know what? That's what I like about this game. It really makes you work for stuff. Like a lot of you I've been noticing, you're like, I haven't had my damn crossbow and I'm on like day 80. It happens, guys. There's always one thing that you cannot find every episode. Or every playthrough. I don't know what is with it. It's almost like the game picks something and it's like, you won't be able to find this. It's going to be extremely rare. Have fun figuring out how to get around it, right? Because, I mean, the crossbow for me is like the weapon. It's the one I like to use. Like, if you guys notice, I don't use guns that much. I don't care about making ammo. It's just, it's kind of cool. Like, if I do have a gun laying around and I did loot ammo, I'll use it up. But for the most part, I prefer the bow. You hit them with a headshot and it's game over, right? But with the gun, you also increase your heat map as well, too, because the noise attracts the zombies. So I like to avoid that, increasing the heat map. Maybe not so much now that I have... Why hasn't there been any zombies? That must have been a pretty big horde over there, because it doesn't look like it spawned in any zombies yet. But the one thing I do hope is at the end of those dirt roads that you guys see, there's supposed to be point of interest in there, like little houses and whatnot and all that other stuff. And for some reason, on random gen, they weren't spawning them in, so you only got the cities and the hub to deal with. And starting off right off the bat, it's easier to choose one of those POIs off of the end of a trail than it is to go into a city, because in the cities you get a lot of zombie spawns. Now you do get zombie spawns in those POIs, but it's not nearly as bad because you don't have multiple POIs sticking around. Nah, it's not zombie. Now I'm just killing zombies for fun too. I could just run by these guys. See what I mean about the headshot, guys? Headshot dead. Doesn't make any noise. It's super cheap to make these. Like, the ammo is super cheap to make. It's feathers, steel arrowheads, and wood. You don't need brass. You don't need to bother with any of that bullcrap. No, I do have a ton of brass now because I've been disassembling cars. But even still, I do prefer the bow over anything else. But, guys, you know what? It's actually been over half an hour now. I've blabbered a lot this episode. I hope I didn't bore you guys because... oh! What? Is that a PO... What? Oh, maybe it's... Oh, it's okay. It's a crossroads. I thought this was a POI that spawned in off of a trail. I was going to say, holy crap, that's the first POI I've ever seen spawn in on a trail. But it seems, guys, I've actually found yet another city. So there's a whole nother city here. Holy crap, guys, this seed's amazing. Skippy 3 is the name of the seed. Skippy and the number 3. I found another damn city. This is so damn cool. Okay, well, now that I've found another city, I think this is a great time to end this episode. So once again, guys, I want to thank you for all your likes, all your support. Remember, guys, always back up your games, especially voxelized games on console. It stops you from having to cry about losing your game saves. I know it sucks, but there is a way around it. And I will see you guys in the next episode. Keep it classy, stay surviving, and peace. We're about to turn it on.